Avevo un servizio esecutivo, cioè io tradurrò in inglese consecutivamente. Mi hanno detto che dovrebbero esserci 10 baie, poi io non ho chiesto individualmente. Ma più che altro deve fermarsi ogni tanto perché io posso tradurre. Lei legge un testo? No, ok. Io prendo appunti di quello che lei dirà e
qualche foto del fondo con tutta la sala lunga
e
viceversa, sì.
Sì. Buonasera a tutti. Grazie ai presenti per questo momento di attenzione e di illustrazione per la nostra regione. Siamo davvero orgogliosi di essere qua. Come ogni anno, il Vinitaly è una importante occasione per fare il punto e valutare il settore che per noi è davvero molto importante. Io sono Mirko Carloni, vicepresidente della Regione Marche e ho la delega al turismo, all'agricoltura e ho il piacere soprattutto di poter rappresentare la nostra regione in questo contesto anche di buyer internazionali e anche di giornalisti del settore vitivinicolo.
Good afternoon and welcome. Thank you for being here at this important appointment for the Marche region. We are very proud to have you here, and every year for us it is an important opportunity to participate at Vinitaly in order to take stock of what is happening in this sector, which is so important to and for my region. My name is Mirko Carloni, and I'm the Vice Governor of the region Marche, and I'm also the Regional Councillor for Tourism and Agriculture. So I represent here the region, and it's a pleasure to meet you, journalists, international buyers.
La partecipazione delle Marche al Vinitaly è da sempre mostrata molto importante. Quest'anno abbiamo l'orgoglio di presentare in questa edizione speciale 12 aziende che rendono giustizia e danno uno slancio alle nostre 21 denominazioni di origine, di cui 5 DOCG, 15 DOC e una IGT. E queste hanno segnalato negli ultimi anni ottime performance e stanno vincendo anche diversi premi.
It is a particular pleasure and honor to be present at Vinitaly for the Marche, and I'm very proud to be here today. We are here at Vinitaly with 12 producers, and we boast as many as 21 appellations in the Marche region. We have 5 DOCGs, 15 DOCs, and one IGT. And again, we're very happy to have this opportunity to present them to you.
Il settore del vino nelle Marche vale 175 milioni di fatturato, di cui 58 di esportazione e 11.000 imprese dedicate al settore vitivinicolo.
In the Marche region, the market, the industry of winemaking is worth 175 million euros in terms of turnover, 58 of which are exported, and we have as many as 11,000 producers.
Abbiamo di fronte un periodo particolarmente importante di investimenti. Recentemente abbiamo realizzato un contributo di 3 milioni di euro per l'OCM Vino che serve proprio alla promozione delle nostre aziende per poter vendere il loro straordinario prodotto nei paesi extraeuropei.
And the time ahead of us is extremely important in terms of the investments that we are going to make. Recently, we allocated as much as 3 million euro for this strategy, the OCM for the wine sector, which is intended to help our, especially small producers, export their production to non-EU countries.
Vorrei ringraziare il settore che si occupa di questo, il dottor Cecconi, i due consorzi di tutela vini che sono rappresentati dal presidente Centocanzi, dal direttore Mazzoni e Alice del consorzio tutela vini Piceni. Abbiamo di fronte una stagione molto importante. Il motivo di questo incontro, a cui tenevo tantissimo, è che recentemente abbiamo fatto un progetto che si chiama Dalla Vigna alla Tavola. Questo progetto ha visto la partecipazione di 300 cantine per creare degli eventi sul territorio marchigiano che hanno dato vita per la prima volta a una grande connessione tra il settore Horeca e la produzione dei vini.
I'm happy to be here in representation of this sector together with representatives of the Consortia for the Protection of Wines in the Marche region, and you have here the president and the director of the consortia, which will take the floor later on. This is a very important season for us. I would like to mention the fact that we had a project that is called From the Vineyard, basically from the vine to the table, whereby 300 wineries participated in organizing events in order to bring closer the Horeca sector with the producers.
Sì, sono particolarmente orgoglioso, in conclusione, di annunciare che nell'arco dei prossimi giorni la Regione Marche si doterà di una legge sull'enoturismo. Per la prima volta avremo una legge regionale che riguarda il settore enoturistico, che possa vedere in un ruolo molto importante le nostre 11.000 aziende vitivinicole e queste possono diventare un luogo di accoglienza turistica, e nel nostro sogno c'è quello di realizzare un movimento del vino attraverso le strade del vino. E dal Vinitaly qui a Verona oggi annunciamo che stiamo, oltre che per approvare la legge, stiamo avviando una grande operazione di marketing territoriale, perché la Regione Marche ha sicuramente molti contenuti agroindustriali, ma soprattutto vitivinicoli, per poter diventare un luogo di turismo attraverso il vino.
I'm also proud to be able to announce here at Vinitaly that in the next days, actually, Marche for the first time will adopt a specific law on wine tourism. And this testifies actually to the important role that we attach to the 11,000 wine growers for the local development in the Marche region, also in terms of hospitality, in bringing the two things together, wine growing and hospitality and tourism. My dream, really, our dream, is that of starting a wine movement, which also will encompass the development of additional wine roads. And so I can tell you here at Vinitaly that not only will we have this law, but we will also apply several initiatives in the field of local marketing, so that the Marche region, which has a strong vocation in the agri-food and in the winemaking sector, can pair that better, even better, with tourism.
Pensiamo che la regione Marche, con le sue bellissime colline e le sue tante aziende, possa diventare una meta per fare un tipo di turismo esperienziale, dove oltre ad assaggiare i tanti vini che appunto sono all'interno delle 21 denominazioni di origine, è una grande esperienza che non ha nulla da invidiare ad altri territori e che ha molto da raccontare di sé. Quindi da oggi parte un rinnovato impegno e anche un rinnovato rapporto tra la Regione Marche, il consorzio di tutela vini e i nostri produttori.
I really believe that the Marche region, with its hills and its producers, can be the best place for people to experience something new, something which goes beyond the tasting, which per se would be already enough of our 21 appellations, but which really becomes in general an experience which is unparalleled, I would say, and certainly as good as the experience that you can also find elsewhere in our country. So this is the start of a new commitment whereby we bring together the commitment of the region, that of the consortia, and the contribution of the producers.
Bene, possiamo anche affermare che la stagione di vendemmia che stiamo vendendo in questo momento, che si sta concludendo nelle Marche, fa emergere un quadro positivo che ha beneficiato anche di un andamento climatico con temperature e un selleggiamento che sta dando uve di ottima qualità, magari con una minore quantità, e tutto questo è un ottimo preludio per un'alta qualità dei nostri vini. Quindi lascio la parola a chi può parlare molto meglio di me dei vini marchigiani, a me soltanto il compito di ringraziarvi e di rappresentare il nostro interesse come regione a far crescere i nostri produttori, a farli conoscere per quello che meritano e per i sacrifici che mettono per fare un vino di ottima qualità. Grazie.
So we definitely can also comment a bit on the harvest season. Harvesting is about to be concluded in the Marche region, and we are very satisfied with it. It is a positive vintage due to the climate. We have had many sun days. The quality of the grapes is excellent. Quantity is a bit reduced when compared to the past. So we have the great precondition to have great wines. So I'm about to leave the floor to the experts of the sector. On my part, let me once again thank you for being here and testify to the fact that we will do our best to support the producers of our region, because they deserve it, because they put so much effort in what they do, and so they have to be supported by us. Thank you very much.
Parola ora al presidente dell'Istituto Marchigiano di Tutela Vini, Antonio Centocanti.
Buonasera, buonasera a tutti, ben trovati, grazie di essere qui. Da quello che ha detto l'assessore avete capito che le Marche è molto disgregata, 21 DOC, tante aziende e quindi il ruolo fondamentale dei consorzi. I consorzi che cercano di organizzare soprattutto la comunicazione la promozione, mettere insieme aziende grandi e aziende più piccoline per far crescere le nostre DOC, i nostri vini.
So the floor has gone now to the president of the Istituto Marchigiano Tutela Vini, Antonio Centocanti. Thank you on my part as well and welcome. As you heard from the voice of the vice governor and regional councillor, the Marche region is a diversified region with as many as 21 appellations and a great number of producers, hence the importance of the consortia, which are paramount in supporting the work of big and small producers alike.
Le Marche è una regione di eccellenze nel mondo del vino e nel mondo dell'enogastronomia. Ha la necessità assoluta di trovare un'identità come territorio Marche. Questo è fondamentale per far conoscere anche i nostri prodotti. Questa è la missione che noi come consorzi cerchiamo di portare avanti sia in Italia e soprattutto all'estero negli ultimi anni. Con l'aiuto della Regione Marche e della Comunità Europea riusciamo a creare bandi e situazioni in cui possiamo dare delle agevolazioni alle aziende per fare tutto questo percorso di comunicazione dei vini marchigiani.
The region Marche is a region of excellence that goes for winemaking, that goes in general for food in addition to wine. Marche has to find its identity. This is absolutely key in order to make our production better known, and this is actually the mission of the consortia both in Italy and abroad. This is where we have worked extensively in latest years, together with the region, of course, with the government of the region, and together with the European Union, so that we have had, and we have, a series of calls and tenders that help producers in this communication effort.
Nelle Marche il mondo dell'agroalimentare rappresenta il 14% del PIL. In nessuna regione d'Italia è così importante questo settore. Dunque è un settore sul quale bisogna assolutamente lavorare, perché siamo terra di eccellenze ma non di grandissime produzioni. Dunque dobbiamo lavorare per dare valore ai nostri prodotti. È la seconda o terza regione in Italia per il biologico, dunque c'è una grandissima attenzione all'ambiente, c'è una grandissima attenzione all'uomo. Si cerca di mantenere il nostro territorio, il nostro ambiente più naturale possibile. Questa per noi è una mission molto molto importante.
In the Marche region, agri-food accounts for 14% of our regional GDP, which is actually the highest percentage in Italy. And this means that we have to work even more, because we are excellent, as we said, but production could be improved, could be more than we do. And it is in this direction that we were working. In addition to that, we rank second or third in Italy in terms of the extension of organic farming and products. This, of course, because we pay a lot of attention to the environment, to the human dimension in that, and we want to keep our region as natural as possible.
Ritengo che l'approvazione della legge da parte della Regione sull'enoturismo sia molto importante, è molto legata al nostro territorio, alle nostre eccellenze, alle nostre bellezze, ma soprattutto anche per mantenere la gente, le aziende, magari nelle zone montane, cioè non scivolare completamente verso il mare, ma mantenere più possibile le zone interne che già con il terremoto hanno avuto tantissimi problemi. Cercheremo assolutamente di aiutarle sotto l'aspetto di un'economia nell'agroalimentare, in modo tale che queste zone interne, anche queste zone interne delle Marche molto belle, continuino ad avere delle attività economiche che danno la possibilità di continuare a vivere ancora nelle Marche, nell'interno delle Marche.
I really think that the law that has been mentioned, the regional law about to be passed about wine tourism, will be extremely important in order to enhance the local territory, the beauty of the various areas in the Marche region, and especially in order to help people continue living and working in mountain areas and not only in the areas close to the seaside. This is our intent. If you also think about what happened after the earthquake and how difficult it can be for people to remain in these more mountainous areas and have the possibility to work there in addition to living there, you understand that we really need to support them. We need these economies in the agri-food sector to flourish so that all of these areas can be economically viable.
Bene, vi ringrazio ancora per la vostra presenza, vi auguro una buona degustazione e sono convinto che i nostri vini vi piaceranno. Grazie.
Once again, thank you very much for being here. I wish you a wonderful tasting and I'm convinced that you will enjoy our wines very much.
Ora grazie, un breve saluto da parte di Marco Pignotti del Consorzio Vini Tutela Vini, diciamo, Piceni.
Buonasera a tutti, benvenuti nelle Marche. Consorzio Vini Piceni è un consorzio che è nato nel 2002 per tutelare le quattro, la DOCG Offida e le altre tre DOC, Rosso Piceno, Falerio e Offida Doc. Per quanto riguarda, il consorzio è composto da 50 soci e copre un bacino d'utenza di oltre 400.000 ettolitri. Considerate che il bacino delle Marche è un bacino molto piccolo, come diceva il collega, è molto frammentato e variegato.
So the floor now has gone to the president of the Consorzio Vini Tutela Vini Piceni, Marco Pignotti. Welcome, welcome to the Marche region. The consortium was established in 2002 in order to better protect the DOCG that we have and the three docks that we have in the area. We count at 50 members and cover, let's say, in terms of production, more than 400,000 hectoliters of wine. As was previously said, the area is small and is diversified, meaning that it is fragmented.
Per raccontare il nostro territorio, qual è il miglior modo se non farlo attraverso i nostri prodotti? Quindi attraverso la degustazione di questi vini, questa sera, sicuramente riuscirete a scoprire le peculiarità e le differenze del nostro territorio.
I think that really the best way to tell about an area is to go through its products, and in this case wine. So what you will do this afternoon is precisely that. Through the tasting, you will have the opportunity not only to taste our wines, but also to perceive and understand their peculiarities and also their differences.
Non mi dilungo e lascio spazio alla degustazione, anche perché il vino poi si scalda nel bicchiere.
So without further ado, let's start with the tasting also, because we don't want wines to get warm.
Bene, grazie. Ora partiamo con il primo vino in degustazione della società agricola Locangeli Aymeric, tenuta di Tavignano. Assaggerete il vino Misco, verdicchio dei Castelli di Jesi, classico superiore 2020. Vi racconta il vino Giulia Sacchi.
Buongiorno, non sono Giulia Sacchi perché ho preso il suo posto, sono Dindera Feld della famiglia della tenuta di Tavignano. L'azienda si sviluppa intorno ai 320 ettari, ma 31 ettari sono di seminativi, 31 ettari sono di vigneto. La famiglia si occupa di agricoltura da più di 5 generazioni, ma da 2 generazioni di vino. Siamo installati nelle Marche dal 1973.
Lasciamo tradurre.
Ondine de la Feld.
So the first wine that you're going to taste is by the Società Agricola Locangeli Aymeric, tenuta di Tavignano. It is a Verdicchio Misco dei Castelli di Jesi, DOC Classic Superior 2020. And the speaker is not the name that you see on the paper that you received, but Ondina della Feld. So, good afternoon, welcome. Our family boasts a farming activity for an area of 320 hectares, 31 of which are vineyards. We have been farming for 5 generations now, 2 generations in the field of wine.
L'azienda si trova a Cingoli, nel comune di Cingoli, a ugual distanza tra il mare e gli Appennini. Riceviamo una forte influenza dal mare dove si incanalano dei venti che arrivano fino alle nostre colline lungo il fiume Musone. Il fiume Musone era chiamato in epoca romana Miscus, da qui il nome del vino Misco. Quindi un vino con caratteristiche di marine, con un'alta influenza dello iodio e del sale, quindi sapidità.
So we are based in the municipality in the area of Cingoli, which is actually halfway between the sea area and the Apennines, and it features strong winds that actually cover these areas to the hills along a river that in ancient times was called Miscus, hence the name Misco for the wine that you're going to taste. The features that you should perceive in this wine are related to a marine environment, marine nuances, so the salt, the iodium and the savoriness of this wine.
Un'altra cosa molto importante, e l'azienda si trova su questi due crinali, da qualche anno abbiamo iniziato a piantare anche a nord per ottenere l'acidità, ma grazie alla posizione delle Marche verso i Balcani riceviamo dei venti forti, freddi, che permettono alla nostra regione di rimanere con un'acidità importante, che è una nota che bisogna mantenere il più possibile nelle caratteristiche del verdicchio.
The estate actually is placed on two slopes, and we have started also producing in the more northern part of the estate in order to boost the acidity of the wine. Remember that due to the position of the region Marche, which, let's say, it's in the direction of the Balkans, we do receive invariably strong winds, cold winds, from the Balkan region, which account for the strong acidity that you find in the wine, which is an important feature for the Verdicchio.
L'altra cosa importante, dal 2018 siamo in produzione biologica. Sicuramente le Marche hanno una grandissima fortuna e noi vogliamo cavalcare questa fortuna. Questi venti e il clima che riceviamo ci permettono di lavorare in biologico senza troppi sforzi, senza troppi trattamenti, senza troppi passaggi e senza dei costi eccessivi. Quindi, nel rispetto di tutta l'Italia che ha delle regioni fantastiche, che hanno più difficoltà, che hanno delle precipitazioni e un clima diverso, ci teniamo a rappresentare, diciamo, il distretto biologico italiano.
Since 2018 we have also expanding our organic production, our organic farming and production. The Marche region is lucky in that respect, because due to the climate, due to the winds, it is not too or excessively difficult, let's say, to be able to abide by the organic farming requirements in terms of the number of treatments and also in terms of the costs that are related to that. There are other regions in Italy which are fantastic, but which are not as lucky as the Marche due to their climate, due to the rainfall. And so we are proud to be emblematic in terms of organic farming and represent Italy in that respect.
L'ultima cosa, lascio spazio agli altri. Il misco è un cru, quindi una parcella selezionata. Le vigne hanno già 30 anni, questo permette una qualità molto alta, perché più l'età è importante nella vigna e più la qualità si può ottenere. Rese basse intorno ai 60 quintali per ettaro. Il vino viene raccolto a mano, una pressa molto leggera per non stressare le bucce, che nel verdicchio la buccia è sottile e può portare eccessiva amarezza. 6 mesi, una vinificazione di 6 mesi in vasca di acciaio, solo acciaio, e un invecchiamento di altri 6 mesi in bottiglia. Il verdicchio nell'invecchiare assume delle note di anice, di miele, che noi riteniamo a Tavignano di mantenere nella sua purezza senza influenzarlo con i profumi e le caratteristiche del legno. Quindi Tavignano lavora con i bianchi solo con l'acciaio.
So a very last thing before giving the floor to the others. It is a cru, the misco that you are tasting, made on one selected plot, vines which are 30 years old. The quality is very high, yield is relatively low, 60 quintals per hectare, hand harvesting exclusively, and a very light pressing, because the skins of the Verdicchio variety are thin, so we don't want to run the risk of having a product which is too bitter. In steel for 6 months and then aged in bottle for an additional 6 months with nuances of anise and honey. At Tavignano, we do want to keep this pure, meaning that we want to retain these features without any influence that would come from wood, which means that we use exclusively steel.
Ci sono domande?
Questions?
Grazie. Ringraziamo
la... tutto. Thank you very much. Grazie a tutti.
Thank you. Ringraziamo l'azienda Lucangeli e ora passiamo all'azienda vitivinicola Umani Ronchi S.p.A. che presenta il vino Vecchie Vigne del 2019, un verdicchio dei Castelli di Jesi Doc, classico superiore. Relatore Giacomo Sisti, che parlerà anche in inglese direttamente. Quindi facciamo riposare un attimo.
Bene.
Ok, grazie.
Hi everyone. So thanks for being here today. Just a few words about Umani Ronchi, just to put in the mood of our philosophy behind the winemaking of the Bianchi Bernetti family. The Umani Ronchi was founded in the 1957, so long time ago, we can say, right after the Second World War, and always focus on the autochthon varieties of Marche region. So Verdicchio, indeed, where Umani Ronchi owns 110 hectares out of the roughly 1,300-1,400 of the classic area of Verdicchio, so a big part of Verdicchio Classico, the Castelli di Jesi. Then we have 70 hectares of Rosso Conero for the other main appellation we have in Marche for the reds, and another estate that I'm not spending too many words today because it's in Abruzzo, our neighbor region to the south. In our history, we have been always focused on the autochthon varieties because we believed a lot in the potential of these wines, and especially in Verdicchio. For Verdicchio today, we are speaking about one of the most well-rated white wine of Italy, one of the most important, in my opinion, wines for Umani Ronchi, especially in the last decade. It's Vecchie Vigne 2019, a relatively young vintage because it was released a few months ago only, and a wine that of course has a very 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 long path on his life, basically. So a very long aging potential. Vecchie Vigne, it's always speaking about territory, because this is a project we can say started in the late 90s when we identified a special plot of Verdicchio that we never replanted at that time. So this is only 4 hectares of a Verdicchio that basically you can track back to the 1968. So over 50 years old vines, 4 hectares only, from which we produce Vecchie Vigne. It's a limited production, of course. We produce every vintage between the 14 and 16 thousand bottles only. The real character of the wine is behind the vine. The vine that in that area of Contrada Le Busche, which is a very tiny piece of land where we produce our Verdicchio, is a soil very, very deep. That's important because when you have old vines, of course, the roots need space to go down and reach particular minerals and a particular soil that you cannot reach in other kind of soils. So in this way, we can really enjoy today this kind of deep and important minerality, the very traditional characteristics of Verdicchio, so some anise, a little bit of fruity notes. On the nose is very important the white flowers and a very distinctive touch, in my opinion, of a kind of smoky parfum, which is not given by the barrel because the wine doesn't touch at all the barrique, but the wine is aged only 1 year in concrete tanks. These are the concrete tanks we built in the late 60s when we built the main facility of Umani Ronchi near the city of Ancona in Osimo, that we refurbished in the early 2000 and that we started to use for Vecchie Vigne. First vintage was made was the 2001, So we have already quite a good library of back vintages of Vecchie Vigne, and so many, I'm sure, will be added in our Verdicchio experience when you taste old vintages of Verdicchio. So hope you will enjoy the baby Vecchie Vigne Verdicchio today, but for sure, for most of you, it will be also fantastic to experience our Verdicchio in another 2, 3, 5, or 10 years or more. So that's it for me. Thank you.
Question?
Microfono.
What's the price point?
So Verdicchio with Vecchie Vigne, we have been always quite steady in the price point, depending of course what are you speaking about. If you export prices or maybe wine shop in Italy, then you can count, let's say you can do the maths, but in Italy is around 20 euros in the Enoteca, in the wine shop.
Export prices
of course is a little bit less, because more or less the half, more or less around 10 euros. Then you have to add, of course, all the costs for logistics and so on. So, and most of the time we sell it on a location, because Umarironk is present in almost 60 countries all over the world. As you can imagine, it's a wine, you know, rated by Wine Advocate, Spectator, and blah, blah, blah. So usually it grabs a lot of interest from the sommelier, from many, many people, as you today. And so we sell it on allocation, but it's a wine we are very, very proud of. We never increase the quantity, so we've been very, very loyal with the customers, because they can experience every time, every vintage, the same quality in our Vecchie Vigne. It's not the wine for Umarironki that changes our life, because as I mentioned at the beginning, we have quite a big property, so also many wines, a good production. But these are the wines that make the proud of the family, of Bernetti family, and the proud of Umarironki and its employees like me. So it's really fun.
Grazie.
Thank you.
Thank you. Ora presentiamo la azienda Casa Vinicola Garofoli S.P.A. con il Podium 2019 Verdicchio dei Castelli di Jesi DOC Classico Superiore. Ne parla David Redondi.
So, vado in inglese.
Vado in inglese, lei direttamente. So you also enjoy directly the English, it's the third wine.
So let's try. So good evening everybody, I'm David from Garofoli. Garofoli, just a quick overview about the winery. Garofoli is a family estate. So today we are on the fifth generation making wine in Marche region. And Podium is one of the iconic wine from our production. We started making Podium in 1991, and since the beginning, the Podium is a wine that we make, making a very long aging. Podium was born after a very long study around the Verdicchio clones. So during the 80s, we were studying the terroir and also the Verdicchio in the area of Monte Carotto. After years and years trying to make a good compromise between vinification, between aging and Verdicchio grape, finally was born the Podium. So Podium is a wine that we age for 1 year and a half using four and a half of the volume concrete and four and a half steel tanks. After that, we usually use to age for another year in the bottle, and then we start to sell. So the 2019 is the current vintage. We just released the vintage in these days. And Podium is a wine for a long aging in the bottle. You can feel even now the tasting is quite fresh in the after tasting. And I think this is one of the most amazing points about Verdicchio. Verdicchio is an incredible variety with this kind of acidity for aging. You know, you can age a Verdicchio very well, and after years, you you can find always this kind of acidity, especially in the after tasting. And this is not just the podium. I think in general, Verdicchio is an incredible grape variety for to make a white for aging. Speaking about 19 podium, yes, we can say that even here, that is young now, you can feel this kind of body. The beginning, you can feel a little bit the evolution given by the aging, but after that, the variety is coming, especially in the after tasting. And this kind of freshness, this kind of texture, it's very, very typical of Verdicchio. So with this kind of wine, we want absolutely to emphasize this kind of style. So freshness, complexity, texture, and also aging potential. Few words about the terroir. Podium is one of the highest vineyards in our property. We are more or less around 400 meters. But one of the most interesting points in this area is the sand. We have a very high concentration of sand in the soil, and this is something that can give us freshness to the tasting. Of course, after podium, speaking about the portfolio, we have also other Verdicchio. But I think podium is like the quintessential of our study around the Verdicchio grape. Thank you.
Question?
So a lot. So we make a Verdicchio base, Serra del Conte, that we usually we age just for few months in steel tanks. Then we have another wine quite famous is Macrina. It's a Verdicchio that was born in 1981. Usually Macrina is like, we can say, a mini podium. We make a very, 6 months of aging in concrete and steel tanks. Then we have a brother of podium, Serra Fiorese. Usually we age Serra Fiorese in barrique, French oak, so more international style. Then also we make Verdicchio sparkling. We have different sparkling with Verdicchio base, Charmant method, Champenoise method. We also make a passito with Verdicchio. So during the years, you know, you must think that Garofoli, the winery was born during the 19th century. So we had many years studying Verdicchio and trying to make Verdicchio in many different ways. And also, I think in general, this kind of variety can give us incredible opportunities, not just to make still wines, but also for sparkling, passito, sweet wine. And I think today you can have a very interesting opportunity to try to understand this kind of texture. And the secret in general is the acidity, the freshness, this kind of complexity you can find in the variety Verdicchio. So from our side, we are very lucky to have an incredible terroir and an incredible grape.
When you say it's great for aging, yeah, what exactly do you mean? Like how much can we age it?
Personally, I made some vertical tasting opening a 98, 99, and everybody found the wine in a very good time. Of course, during the aging, you can find many different flavors, many different tasting. Of course, sometimes during the aging, especially with the podium, we found that there is a moment going down and then a little bit up, depend of the vintage. But I can really say that you can age without any problem, minimum 20 years. But of course, if you want a secondary flavor tasting, if you want that kind of tasting, if you want to enjoy the wine young, I think right now it's tasting well. Personally, I recommend 1 year more of bottling for the tasting.
Grazie. Ora passiamo a Casal Farneto. Presentano il Gran Casale Verdicchio dei Castelli di Jesi Doc, classico superiore 2018, relatore Ulisse Patalocchi.
Hello everybody and welcome. I'm Ulisse Patalocchi, export manager of the winery Casal Farneto. Casal Farneto is a winery family owned dating back 1995, so we are 26 years old. And since the very beginning, we love to experiment the possibilities given by the Verdicchio grape. Some of my colleagues might have said that we call the Verdicchio the red grape dressed in white because we can play a lot with this grape. And the same we do. We do play with the harvest time, with the winemaking process, by using the steel, the concrete, the oak, or the big cask, or botrytis, passito. So at the moment, we produce 10 different Verdicchio. And 9 of them are made just in the same vineyard. So we passed by a few times within 1 month, so early, regular, and later harvest. And we play also with a different winemaking technique to make all this broad range of Verdicchio possibilities. So from Charmat method to Champenoise, we do also Classico, Superiore in stainless steel, Cryo maceration, we do barrel fermented Riserva, we do Botrytis, Passito in the Vinsanto way, we do also one IGT, which is a little bit more experimental, like Burgundy style. And in the end, 3 years ago, we also launched 2 artisanal vermouths made with 75% Verdicchio, because we, by using a nice base of wine, also we are able to increase the quality itself of the vermouth. So today we are showing you one of the first 3 Verdicchio that we produced at the very beginning. At the very beginning, we had 1 stainless steel, 1 Cryo macerated, and 1 botrytis. So we are tasting the Cryo maceration one. Gran Casale, we pick up the grapes slightly late, so usually 1 week to 10 days after the regular harvest time. And soon after we press the grape, we leave the skins in contact with the juice at low temperature, between 0 and 4 degrees Celsius. This way, we don't have an interchange of color, interchange like tannins. We just have a little bit more characteristic style from the Verdicchio grape. So after these 10, 12 hours in contact with the skin, we remove them. We raise the temperature to the fermentation temperature, which is around 18 degrees Celsius, and we start the fermentation. After the fermentation, we put up to 20% of the wine in a big Slavonian oak of 25 hectoliters for at least 6 months, maximum 8 months, so 6 to 8 months. So this way the oak is there, but you don't feel it. You just increase the complexity of the wine, making a little bit rounder, bigger, a little bit more velvety on the palate. And we have a richer Verdicchio. 2018 has been also a very interesting vintage. It was a fresher vintage compared to the 2017. This way, even if we have a slightly late harvest, we are able to preserve the acidity level, which is also very interesting. So if you taste it, you feel the acidic profile of the wine, which is also very present. It's 3 years old and it's a young baby. Like the Podium, also the Gran Casale is one of the Verdicchio that can age certainly very well. Myself, I didn't go back to 98, but certainly I tasted 2006 and it was a very beautiful wine. So really with the Verdicchio, you can dare to put one case in the cellar and open one bottle every year and taste it year by year and see the differences. So well, the Gran Casale is certainly one of the top important wines for us. We do also have a Riserva, which is barrel fermented, but certainly this one keeps us more tied with the old style of our wines. When we launched this in 95, it was an IGT. For 3 vintages, we didn't call it DOC. because it was very different in the winemaking. The cryomaceration, the oak usage was not really something which was well perceived or accepted, let's say, in the past. So after 3 years, we managed to move it to the DOC and start the promotion as a Verdicchio dei Castelli di Jesi. So with Casal Farneto, we started this year in April. We changed winemaking consultant and we hired one of the most important winemaker for the conversion to organic. So we started experimental changes in the in the agronomic system, and probably in 3 to 4 years all the production will move to the organic. So thank you very much, and any question is well accepted.
The question?
Stefano Chioccioli. He consult now for Livio Felluga. In the past with Tuarita, he scored 100 point Parker, so is certainly a very well experienced hand. And also for us, it's important, which is also an agronomist and knows how to play in the vineyard to move to the organic.
Okay, next question.
Yeah, you talked about cryo maceration. I was wondering, apart from the aromatic complexity, does it gives any anything else to the texture of the wine? Let's say what other aspects, characteristic cryomaceration gives to the wine, in your wines, I mean.
Yes, certainly it increases the structure, because in any case you have a contact with the skins, so certainly there's an increase in structure. Even though at the low temperature we are able to preserve the part from the tannic or the color interchange. So we are able to just add a touch, yes, characteristic style, but also a little bit of structure.
Thank you. Grazie.
Thank you.
Passiamo ora a Terre Cortesi Moncaro, Verdicchio DOCG, riserva Vigna Novali 2016. Ne parla De Paola Gianluigi.
Nice to meet you. Welcome to everyone. The first thing I'm wondering to see you, to meet you in person again. This is the first time I can meet you, because during this year we made a lot of tasting online, and so I suppose it is not a good idea for wine. It's better to meet you personally, to speak about wine personally, because the exchange of the emotions, I'm sure. It's the best thing to explain the wine. I'm Gianluigi De Padova. I worked as a winemaker for many years. And since now I'm working in the exports department. Moncaro, my company, my winery, it was founded in 1964 in Monte Carotto, in the heart of Verdicchio dei Castelli di Jesi area. And we acquired all two wineries in different area to produce other kind of wines, typical wines, DOC wine, typical of the Marche region in Camerano and Acqua Via Picena, in other DOC area. But our core, our most important wine and grape is Verdicchio. This wine is a DOCG wine, called the Vigna Novali, because this wine is a cru. It's made from grape harvested and produced in our vineyard called Novali in Castelplanio. This is a hill. On the top of this hill and on the slope of this hill, there are these ancient this ancient vineyard. This is a very, very old clone, because Verdicchio has a great variability. So we have different kind of clones. This is a very old clone. and a particular kind of vineyards rich, and these particular vineyards receive a lot of marine breeze that arrive inside a wall, inside a valley, and arrive on the top of this particular vine. So there is no humidity, it's very dry, and there is a particular kind of soil rich in sand and broken rocks. So we can find in this wine a lot of minerality for this reason. And this particular condition make naturally permit us to produce, to have a very low yield. So we produce maximum 70, 80, 60, minimum 6 for quinta, so 6-7 tons per hectare. So as you can see, is a very low production. This particular condition suggested to us to produce with this grape a wine suitable to be aged. This vintage is 2016. A very good harvest because the climate condition during here was very balanced. The hot arrived at the right time, the rain arrived at the right time. So the grove or the vineyards, the cluster grew very in a very good way. There were no problem for the ripening of the grape. This grape, this cluster are harvested in the last part of the harvest, when they are totally mature and over ripened. And in some cases, when the conditions are good, when there is a very dry condition, no humidity, we permit the presence of botrytis, noble mud. Okay, this is very important to give to the wine a particular expression complexity at the end. So the clusters are harvested by hand, obviously, selected and harvested by hand. Then there is, as my colleague said before, there is a brief cryo maceration with skins for not more than 2 hours. And to get more complex, it a particular kind of smell, a particular nose, but not only for the smell, but or the complexity for the taste, to have a very, very high dry extract too. Because these 2 hours are not so, are important, but are not the most important thing. Then we have a very slow fermentation with controlled yeast. We used some yeast selected by very ancient clone of yeast. We have a collaboration with the University of Ancona to find and to refine these particular old clones of yeast, autochthonous yeast. And then after the fermentation, the wine matures about 10 months apart in still tanks on the lees. We make the Surly method. We make agitation with batonnage method. Okay, this is very important to obtain very round taste. Is very important because on the walls of the cell of lees of the yeast, there are very important substances such as mannoprotein or polysaccharides. This is very important for this kind of a very high structured wine. This is very important for the final product, for the final tasting. And another part is aged in used barrique. Oak, French oak barrique, part Allier and part Slavonia, and then is matured in bottle for a minimum. In total, the maturation is minimum 2 years. But please, this wine was produced in the harvest 16, and this is our current vintage we are selling now. So the minimum is 2 years, but these are 5 years after the harvest. But we tasted a lot of very, very, very old vintage of Vigna Novali, such as 2001, 2002, 2007, and the high dry extract, our minerality, our particular condition of this grape before and wine after. permit to the wine to have a very, very long life. At nose, the first thing is that at nose, the wine during time, during thanks to the oxidation change in the glass during time. But the most important hints are the citrus, white fruit, particular taste of hints of honey too. But the most important hints is Mediterranean flora. In mouth, it's very, very well balanced. Very high alcohol. This is 14 degrees alcohol, but the high alcohol is well balanced with a particular taste, around taste, and we can find after 5 years some very high acidity because we have a high presence of malic acid due to the particular condition. And you can find in mouth the sapidity. So this particular salt, this is due to, as I said before, is very rich in broken, disaggregated rocks. So we have a big amount of minerals. This is very important for the complexity in the mouth. But as I said before, the change this wine in the glass. About pairing, as example, I prefer to drink this wine alone for meditation without pairing with any kind of food. But you can pair with seafood, obviously, risotto, pasta in bianco, not with red sauce, no? And it's very good with very high structured grilled fish or fried fish too. But it's good to pair it with white meat too, and in some cases, truffle. I hope you enjoy it. I love it. I love this wine personally. I love this aspect of this wine that changed during the tasting. Any kind of questions, I'm available for you.
Okay.
Thank you to you.
Grazie.
Thank you for supporting us. It's very important for our work.
Ora torniamo con le cantine Belisario che presenteranno il verdicchio di Metelica Riserva di OCG Cambrugiano 2018 e lo racconta il presidente Antonio Centocanti.
Sì, rieccomi. Finalmente un verdicchio di Metelica, verdicchio di montagna, nell'interno delle Marche, una vallata nord-sud, una delle pochissime vallate in Italia nord-sud, penso che ce ne siano tre o quattro, parallela al mare, una vallata completamente chiusa verso il mare. Per arrivare da noi bisogna fare le gallerie.
So, wine number six. Finally, we have a Verdicchio di Metelica. This Verdicchio is produced in mainland markets, a mountainous area in a valley which actually follows the direction north to south. There are very few of them in Italy, possibly three or four. So, a valley which runs parallel to the sea, and we are absolutely closed in, meaning that to reach the valley, you have to go through tunnels.
Sì, la grande caratteristica è la escursione termica, 20, 21, 22 gradi di differenza tra il giorno e la notte, clima continentale. Pensate che tre giorni fa ha fatto meno 3 gradi, cioè ha già gelato. Dunque è caldo di giorno e freddo di notte. Questo è quello che caratterizza fortemente il Verdicchio di Metelica e è il motivo per il quale ci sono due DOC, Verdicchio Castelli di Jesi e Verdicchio di Metelica, che tra un po' di tempo si chiamerà Matelica Doc, proprio per far capire l'identità, la forza di questo, quanto questo territorio incide su questo vitigno. È un'area piccola, 350 ettari di vigneto, molto più piccolo rispetto a Jesi, è completamente diversa.
The main feature is the huge temperature difference between daytime and night. So you can have as many as 20 to 22 degrees Celsius difference. Continental climate. Imagine that just a few days ago we went down to minus 3 degrees at night, so it has already frozen. Warmed at day again and cold at night. This is the feature that you then find also in the glass, in the wine that you're going to taste. This is also the reason why we have two DOCs, Verdicchio Castelli di Jesi and Verdicchio di Matelica, which will soon change its name and become a Matelica DOC, Matelica DOC, in order to stress the very specific identity of this grape variety and hence the wine. The area here is 350 hectares, so much smaller than the Jesi area.
Le Cantine Belisario è un'azienda cooperativa nata 50 anni fa, quest'anno festeggiamo i 50 anni. Sono 100 soci che conferiscono uva alla nostra cantina. Questa cantina vuol dire il 70% del Verdicchio di Matelica. Dunque la cantina più importante. È una cooperativa particolare perché i soci non possono gestire il vigneto come vogliono, ma devono essere parte di un progetto qualità gestito e controllato dalle Cantine Belisario.
Cantine Belisario is actually a cooperative and we celebrate this year our 50th anniversary. 100 members supply the grapes to the winery, and this covers 70% of the Verdicchio di Matelica, which means that this winery is extremely important for this variety and for this wine making, for this wine, sorry. It is a special cooperative, meaning that members cannot simply do as they please in their farming practices. They have to be part of a project, which is a quality project, which is governed and managed by Cantine Belisario.
Logicamente la produzione per ettaro delle uve è molto bassa, quindi è normale che l'azienda ha come obiettivo di fare vini di una fascia medio-alta. Cioè, a Matelica è difficile produrre più di 90-100 quintali di uva per ettaro.
Logically, production per hectare is very low, and this means that what we want to do is wine which is destined to a medium and top end category. It is very difficult to go beyond, to exceed 90 to 100 quintals per hectare.
La Belisario, oltre che cooperativa, ha anche 80 ettari di vigneto di sua proprietà, che conduce direttamente.
In addition to being a cooperative, Belisario also has and manages 88 hectares of its own property.
E ha anche 4 enoteche, proprio enoteche, cioè non punti vendita, ma proprio enoteche dove vengono commercializzate 1100-1200 etichette, migliori etichette dei vini italiani e anche non italiani. Il Cambrugiano è un Verdicchio di Matelica DOCG, riserva, produzione massima per ettaro 85-90 quintali, e fa criomacerazione. Dopo il primo travaso un 10% viene messo in barrique francesi di primo, secondo e terzo passaggio, e questo 10% rimane in barrique per circa un anno. Il resto del prodotto fa acciaio. Dopo un anno viene rifatto il blend, dopo un po' di tempo viene imbottigliato e minimo 4 mesi di maturazione in bottiglia.
We also have 4 wine bars, by which I mean really places where you can taste 1,800 labels of wines from Italy and also from other countries. Cambrugiano is a DOCG Riserva. Production is maximum 85 to 90 quintals per hectare, cryo maceration, and after the first racking off, 10% is put into French oak, first, second, or third use, and after and the rest for 1 year, sorry, and the rest goes into steel. So after 1 year, the two are blended again and then bottled, and it ages in bottle for at least 4 months.
Oggi vengono prodotte circa 85.000 bottiglie. Il Cambrugiano negli ultimi 2 anni è il vino bianco fermo in Italia che ha avuto su 6-7 guide più importanti d'Italia il massimo dei punteggi. Dunque questo è un po' la garanzia di quello che oggi vuol dire questo prodotto. È un 2018. Quando lo assaggiate sentirete ancora una grande freschezza, perché noi abbiamo in cantina ancora il 1988, quello la prima annata del Cambrugiano, e ancora gustiamo molto bene il 94, il 95, il 96, ha una longevità incredibile.
Today, production is approximately 85,000 bottles. The Cambrugiano that you are tasting is actually, as a still white wine, the wine that has got top scores invariably in all guides about wines in Italy. So this is really a warranty of what this wine is. And this has been going on for a couple of years now. It is a 2018 vintage. It is still fresh, as you can certainly taste, but remember that in our winery, in our cellar, we still have the 1988 production, so the very first year where we produced this wine, and we normally taste the 1994, 5, and 6, which really accounts, which means a very significant longevity for this wine.
Il verdicchio di Materica è un vino molto strutturato, poco aromatico, ha nelle sue caratteristiche la sapidità e la mineralità. Questo vino deve essere abbinato con piatti abbastanza saporiti. Può arrivare molto bene anche al maiale, all'agnello, carni grasse, non proprio carni rosse, dove c'è un grande sapore, dove questo vino riesce anche a pulire la bocca dalla parte grassa di queste carni. E in più naturalmente può essere abbinato anche con piatti di pesce, arrosti, crostacei, molto saporiti.
So this verdicchio di Matelica is structured. It's not excessively aromatic, absolutely savory. You can certainly appreciate its minerality. So it has to be paired with something which is equally savory, pork meat, not so much the red meat perhaps, but certainly the fatty parts of meat as well go very well, also because in a way its taste cleans the mouth after these plates, after these dishes, and crustaceans and fish alike.
Bene, se c'è qualche domanda, the question.
Other questions?
Moment, micro.
So that I understand properly, this is a DOCG, and then earlier you mentioned that you're going to be reversing back to DOC.
Diceva all'inizio che questa è una DOCG, ma ha parlato della DOC, ha detto che cambierà il nome Matelica DOC.
No, sì, sì. Di conseguenza cambierà nome anche la DOCG, si chiamerà Matelica Riserva DOCG. cioè Madelica DOC e Madelica Riserva DOCG.
So as a consequence also these, the DOCG will change its name, so you will have both Madelica DOC, which is one, and Madelica Riserva DOCG, which is what this will become.
Punteremo molto più sul territorio che sul vitigno.
We will focus very much on the terroir more than the variety.
Ok, grazie.
Grazie. Grazie.
Ora passiamo all'ultimo bianco, Guido Cocci Grifoni e la, diciamo, azienda con il Colle Vecchio Fida Pecorino di OCG del 2020. E ne parla Marilena Cocci Grifoni.
Hi, this is Marilena. I talk about the Colle Vecchio Fida Pecorino di OCG. It's the vintage is 2020. I don't know if you have heard the story of this grape. The Pecorino grape was completely completely forgotten after the Second War, and the story is in my family. The roots are in my family because my father, Mr. Guido, beginning of 80, had the vision to go back to our Sibillini mountain for rediscovering and for saving from the extinction of this grape. So we have planted the first vineyard at Pecorino in 1987, and since 1990 we have been bottling Pecorino pure. It's the vintage 2020 has been a regular vintage despite of this last one, the 2021, that has been extremely hot. It's a very early bird grape. We have to run for harvesting generally at the around 22-23rd of August for saving the acidity. The production per hectare is very low. We are between 6-7 ton, and the vinification is in white. It's just still and the refining in glass. I don't talk too much about the wine because I don't want to take too much time to you. If you have some question about this wine, I am here.
Question? Moment.
Sorry.
Thank you.
In general, as far as Pecorino versus other varietals for white, what's the spread within the whole area?
If we compare to other family, Pecorino is a very single family. There is no touch to Trebbiano family, where there is also the Passerina. They are very, very far between each other, because by Pecorino, we can have the guarantee to age this wine. We have now a wine library where we have collected all the old vintages starting from 1990. And I opened some old vintages like 2010 or 2009, and they are extremely interesting in terms of the aging and the longevity, because we have an important detail. It's the acidity. The acidity is the back of the wine, and it performs like a red wine. Maybe if we close the door, the eyes, we can. We don't know if we have in our mouth a white or red wine. And it's completely different. Maybe this grape didn't reach us by the Roman vessel from Greece from Mediterranean to Italy. Maybe it reached us by Germany, by Mid-Europe to Italy, always by Roman, from Gallia to Rome. Maybe. Because we have found in at 700 meters above sea level.
Thank you. Grazie.
Grazie.
Ora iniziamo con i vini rossi.
So we now start.
Iniziamo con la Canosa, con il Nummaria Rosso Piceno Superiore DOC, e ce ne parla Riccardo Reina.
Buonasera. If you don't mind, I go in Italian because it's more precise to for my English. Thank you. La Canosa è una tenuta di 100 ettari che giace subito a nord di Ascoli Piceno e ha il vantaggio di possedere entrambi i lati delle vallate, della vallata del fiume Tesino. È un vantaggio perché in questo modo abbiamo potuto allevare le diverse varietà di vite con una giacitura che meglio le valorizza.
La Canosa is a 100 hectare estate north of Ascoli Piceno, and it has a major advantage. It includes both slopes of the valley of the river Tesino. Why is it an advantage? Because in this way we can grow the varieties, the grape varieties, picking exactly the right position for them to grow at best.
Okay. La posizione della Canosa è ai piedi dei Monti Sibillini ed è in una posizione nella quale, da qui prende il nome la Canosa, i monaci benedettini già nel 1200 coltivavano uva proprio in questa vallata. Hanno la Canosa prende il nome da Poggio Canoso, un borgo medievale ancora intatto.
The position of Canosa is right at the foot of the Sibillini Mounds. There, Benedictine monks, already back in 1200, grew the vines and made wines. So the name Poggio Canoso is referring to a place, a town that already existed during the Middle Ages.
Okay. Il terreno, la storia geologica dei nostri terreni è quella dell'Appennino in sé. In realtà sono marne alterate di calcare che presentano diverse colorazioni e possiamo con queste, come ho detto prima, ottimizzare le nostre vigne che così vengono esaltate a seconda dell'impasto del terreno.
The geology is the typical geology of the area of the Apennines, but actually it is altered marls of limestone with different colors. The fact that we do have this range and variety, again, leads us back to what we said before. We can optimize the position depending on the soil in order to achieve the best with our vine growing.
Nel nostro caso, questo vino è fatto con uve Montepulciano e Sangiovese che oggi ancora noi non abbiamo raccolto perché l'altitudine sul livello del mare è fino a 570 metri sul livello del mare e non hanno ancora completato la loro maturazione.
This wine is made with Montepulciano and Sangiovese grapes. As a matter of fact, this year we have not harvested them yet because it is as high as 570 meters above sea level, so they are not fully ripe yet.
Benissimo. La escursione termica che noi riusciamo ad avere nella nostra tenuta è molto alta, perché siamo proprio ai piedi dei Monti Sibillini, a 35 km dal mare, ma direttamente esposti all'inversione termica. Quindi abbiamo un enorme vantaggio, usiamo pochissima chimica, non siamo biologici, ma grazie a questa aria, a questa ventilazione, non dobbiamo trattare le vigne quasi per niente.
Actually, we really benefit and exploit the temperature difference that is present there, which is very high, because we are at the feet of the foot of the Sibillini Mountains, 35 kilometers away from the sea, and we are exposed to the thermal inversion phenomenon fully, which means that even though we are not organic farmers, we treat very little with chemical products our vines, because we do not need that simply due to the climate conditions.
Difficilmente riusciamo a raccogliere più di 80 quintali ad ettaro.
Hardly do we manage to harvest more than 8 tons, 80 quintals per hectare.
Ok, veniamo quindi al vino. È un rosso Piceno Superiore DOC, composto dal 70% di Montepulciano e il 30% di Sangiovese.
So, now the wine. It is a Rosso Piceno Superiore DOC, 70% Montepulciano and 30% Sangiovese.
Le vigne hanno una densità per ettaro da 4.545 a 5.680, significa una densità di 2,20 m per un metro o 2,20 m per 80 centimetri.
In terms of vine density, from 4,545 to 5,680 vines per hectare, which means 2.2 meters by 1 meter or 2.2 by 80 centimeters.
Vabbè, vinificazione fatta con la tradizionale destemming, le vigne sono a cordone speronato, abbiamo una vinificazione a temperature maniacali, cioè noi abbiamo questa questa voglia di controllare la vita dei nostri vini, e abbiamo una cantina che porta i controlli delle temperature in ognuna delle fasi di produzione, sia dal ricevimento delle uve che vengono trattate in neve carbonica, fino all'affinamento in bottiglia, sempre a temperatura controllata.
So, in terms of vinification, it is part cordon, the training system, then traditional destemming for vinification, and I must stress that we are absolutely obsessed and maniac about temperature control during the vinification. So we want to control the life of our wines, that's the truth. And this means encompasses all phases of the wine making process, from the moment we receive the grapes and we add the carbon to the moment of bottle aging. Each and every step is temperature controlled.
Ok, la particolarità del Rosso Piceno e del Rosso Piceno Superiore in questo caso è che è un assemblaggio di due vitigni. I due vitigni hanno vita separata sia nelle maturazioni, nella vendemmia, che nell'affinamento. Quindi hanno legni diversi, tempi diversi. l'assemblaggio è fondamentale per riuscire a dare una trama al vino che non comporti la sensazione di avere due vini diversi che convivono. Ecco perché qua troviamo un 2016, perché minimo deve lavorare 2 anni, un anno in legno, un anno in bottiglia, ma poi gli dobbiamo dare il tempo di amalgamarsi e il consiglio che noi diamo è da 4 a 5 anni per essere al meglio delle sue possibilità.
Rosso Piceno, in this case Rosso Piceno Superiore, is actually the blend of the two varieties. The two grapes are harvested separately and the whole process is separate, so aging in different oaks and so on and so forth, which means that it's fundamental then to give the wine the possibility to have a texture which is not reminiscent of the fact that you have two different varieties and then wines, which is the reason why you have a 2016 vintage here, because you have to have minimum 2 years, one in wood and one in the bottle, and then 1 year, let's say, for the optimum blending of the two. This is the reason why we recommend that you wait at least 4 to 5 years in order to be able to taste this wine in its best condition.
Ok, lo possiamo degustare e troviamo il suo sapore caldo, vellutato, dato da tannini propri del vino, ma anche data dalla trama sottile che gli è stata data e conferita da legno molto grande nel caso del Sangiovese e di Tunno per il Montepulciano.
So we can now taste it, hot, velvety. This derives from the tannins of the wine itself, and the texture, which is very fine, derives from the fact that two different sizes of barrels are used, the large ones in the case of the Sangiovese and the small barrels, the oaks, for the Montepulciano.
Gli abbinamenti sono tipicamente su carni, sia arrosto che alla brace, e formaggi stagionati e tutto ciò che viene dal nostro territorio, il tartufo in primis.
Pairings are typically meat, both roasts and grilled meat, seasoned cheese and truffle. So everything which is peculiar of our terroir and of our area.
Grazie.
Thank you.
Grazie. Question?
How many wines do you produce?
In total, it's about 280.000 bottiglie. Di questo vino siamo intorno ai 20.000.
280,000 bottles of this wine, 20,000. Did you ask about how many different wines? Chiedeva più che altro quanti vini diversi, non la quantità.
Pecorino, Passerina, Rosso Piceno Superiore, Passerina spumantizzata, nel nostro caso un esperimento di quest'anno, il Sangiovese spumante rosso, e abbiamo una parte che si sta sviluppando sugli internazionali, che sono Merlot e Cabernet.
In addition to the initial list of the names of wines, we also experiment this year with the Sangiovese Spumante Red, and we have an international part, Merlot and Cabernet.
Ok, grazie.
Grazie a tutti.
Passiamo ora alla Cantina dei Colli Ripani, con l'Uffida Rosso di OCG, Leo Ripano del 2017, e ce ne parla Alice Pulcini.
Good afternoon. to everyone. My name is Alice Pulcini and I'm the sales export manager of the company. Cantina Colli Lipani was born in 1979 thanks to the cooperation of some local farmers. So we are a cooperative company. Today we have more than 300 farmers that bring the grapes to the cooperative. We are located in a small town in the province of Ascoli Piceno. The name of the town is Ripa Tranzone. And we are between the Adriatic Sea and the Apennine Mountains at an altitude of 300 meters upon sea level. Today we are going to taste one of the wine of our top level collection. The collection is named 508. And it's an exclusive collection of six premium products with international and international acclaim for their history and their value and for their quality. We are 508 meters upon sea level on the Colle San Nicolò, that is the highest point of Ripa Tranzone. The wine we are going to taste is Anofida Rosso, the OCG, and it's a blend of two varieties, Montepulciano and Cabernet Sauvignon. The percentage of Cabernet Sauvignon is small comparing with the Montepulciano. As we can see from the glass, the color is very dark red. The vintage is 2017. We produce around 2,000 bottles for this wine. We vinificate in red, and the maceration with the skins is very long. And the wine is stored in a barrique for almost 20 months and moreover 3 months in the bottle for fining. This is a very awarded and wine and which is very appreciated to for again a customer. For example, we have a market in Quebec. We won a tender for this wine. If you have some question, I'm here.
Question?
Non ho capito.
Okay.
We produce complexity. We produce 1 million bottles, but for this wine, it's around 2,000 bottles per year. Montepulciano 19% and 10% of Cabernet Sauvignon.
Bene, grazie.
Bravo.
Ora abbiamo velenosi, Roggio del Filare, Rosso Piceno DOC Superiore del 2018 e ce ne parla Marzio Germano.
Marco Germano.
Marco.
Okay. Hello everybody, my name is Marco Germani, I'm in charge of export for the winery Velenosi. We are one of the biggest wineries in the region of Le Marche. So 2.5 million bottles, 300 hectares of property. We sell wines from supermarkets to Michelin star restaurants. And the wine that you are about to taste today is the most important wine for Velenosi because it's the flagship, the most awarded wine. And I tell you something which makes us very, very proud is that every year there is a magazine that makes the ranking of the best 100 red wines of Italy by combining the six most important Italian wine guides. So Gambero Rosso, Luca Maroni, Veronelli, IES, the six most important guides. So we're not speaking about a single guide that maybe you are a friend with the journalist and they give you a high score. It's six guides and these people, they don't even get along very well with each other. In the vintage 2016, Roggio ranked at number four in the list of the top 100 red wines of Italy. And if you look at this ranking, you can see that the first one, of course, is Sassicaia. Then you have Tignanello. You have all the best of the best of the Italian enology. And most importantly, if you look at the price of Sassicaia, probably with the price of a bottle of Sassicaia, you can buy a case, a whole case of Roggio del Filare, the wine that you have in the glass. So this is big opportunity for the drinker, for you and for your customers, because you can drink a wine which is rated among the best of the best in Italy. But of course, it's not at the same price point of Sassicaia or the other famous wine. This, of course, because the denomination Rosso Superiore, Rosso Piceno Superiore, is not a brand. And you know, when you're buying a Brunello, an Amarone, or a Barolo, a little bit or even a lot you're paying for the brand. So a few words about the wine. This is, as my colleagues said before, Rosso Piceno Superiore is the most ancient wine, the appellation of the region of Le Marche. It's a blend of Montepulciano and Sangiovese, 70% Montepulciano, 30% Sangiovese. In this case, we are speaking about the best vines that Velenosi has. So oldest vines, 60 to 80 year old, best sun exposition, best soil, lowest yield in the field. And of course, this is the best that our region, that our estate can produce. The wine itself, the two wines are follow completely separate routes. So they are vinified separately. They are aged separately, new barrique, medium toast French oak. And then at the end, we make the blend. Even the berries are picked at different times, the Montepulciano being a later picked, harvested blend. So why, since ancient time, people decided to blend Montepulciano and Sangiovese? The reason is very easy, because Montepulciano is a strong, powerful, full mouth, big tannin wine, and Sangiovese is more complex. It has more elegance. So to blend a little bit of Sangiovese, 30% of Sangiovese, with the Montepulciano, you still have the strength, the power, the force of Montepulciano, but you have this layer of complexity. So you have this extra layer of finesse that Sangiovese gives to the wine. This made the success of the wine. We produce about, according to the vintage, 30 to 50,000 bottles. This very vintage, so the wine that the 2020, which will come out in 3 years, it has been a difficult vintage, as many of my colleagues already told you. So we will not have a huge quantity. The wine is sold only on allocation, because we're in the good position of having a lot more demand than possibility to supply. So we have to tell to our importers to tell us the quantity that they want for the vintage, and you can find it in the Michelin star restaurants around the world. If you have any question? Okay, for the export, we're speaking about 16 euro ex cellar, 16 euro per bottle ex cellar.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Infine, poderi del Conero, Rosso Conero DOC 2016, il Casirano Conte Leopardi. Ce ne parla Davide Orru.
Hello, my name is Davide Orru. I'm the sales manager of the winery Conte Leopardi. This company has a lot of history, was founded in 1864 by the Leopardi family. That is one of the most ancient families that we have in Le Marche. The family arrived in the fourth century in Osimo, and the Conte Pier Vittorio Leopardi that owns the winery today becomes from this family. Probably you have heard about Giacomo Leopardi, the famous poet. He is part of the Leopardi family as well. As I said, the company was founded in 1864, but they started to grow grapes 100 years later in 1964. The Conte Leopardi had a lot of land in the area of the Conero, and with these calcareous soils, he decided that he wanted to grow the Montepulciano grapes. And this happened in 1964, so before the appellation Rosso Conero was even created. So he has been really, really one of the first to grow Montepulciano. In a few years later, he started to grow Sauvignon Blanc as well. This is due to the fact that the soil was very, very calcareous in the area. And so he had the idea that he could make a really, really good Sauvignon Blanc wine from these vineyards. You have to consider that in the early 70s, Sauvignon Blanc was not even allowed to be grown in Le Marche, in the Ancona province. So it took him some years to get the Sauvignon Blanc, you know, authorized in the area. The company owns 45 hectares of vineyards, basically located in three areas: Numana, Sirolo, and a small parcel in Castelfidardo. But 90% of the vineyards are in Sirolo and Numana, that are two little towns on the seaside, just behind of the Conero mountain. We grow basically Montepulciano and Sauvignon Blanc, as I said, but we have some small parcels of Cabernet Sauvignon and even Syrah. The wine that we are going to taste today is a Casirano. There's a funny story about the name, because it's a Rosso Conero DOC, but Casirano means Cabernet, Syrah, and Montepulciano, because when we first started the production of this wine, was a blend of three different grapes. But obviously, we are on the Conero area, and so the Count Leopardi decided to stop the production of the international varieties to grow only Montepulciano. And so we started producing the Rosso Conero DOC Casirano, but we maintained the original name. We have a 2016 vintage to taste today. It's a Rosso Conero DOC made with 100% Montepulciano grape. According to the appellation, we are allowed to use even up to 15% of Sangiovese, but all our wines are made with only Montepulciano. It's a traditional red fermentation with 20 days on the skins. The idea is to make wines that have good relation with the territory, with the grape. After the fermentation, we age the wine in oak barrels. We tend to use normally half and half, so half new wood and half used wood. It's 215 liters barriques. All our vineyards are organic farmed. So many, many years. And the production of bottles, it's quite small. Of Casirano, of this vintage, that it's only made in really, really good vintages, we only produce around 3,000 bottles. The total production of the winery, it's just around 200,000 bottles, not more. The wine, as I said, it's very fruity. We don't want the Montepulciano to be too tannic, so we don't keep the wine too long on the skins during the fermentation, and we tend to have a very long aging even in bottle after the wood aging, because Montepulciano has very strong tannins and can be very, very powerful, and sometimes even if the tannins is too strong, not so easy to drink. So we keep to even 2 years in the wine cellar before actually we start selling the wine. If there are any questions, I'll be more than happy to answer.
Sorry? It's eight euros, Excella. You're welcome.
Bene, altro? Sorpresa?
Grazie.
Thank you very much. I hope you enjoy this long tasting.
Avevamo saltato prima l'azienda agrobiologica San Giovanni e ora ce lo racconta in maniera, diciamo, rapida Alice Curatola con per il Leo Guelfus Rosso Piceno Superiore 2017.
We had left out number 9, the Leo Guelfus Agrobiologica San Giovanni, and Alice Curatola will tell us about the wine now.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Unfortunately, the owner of San Giovanni Winery can be present today, so I will do my best to try to explain you their reality and their winery. San Giovanni Winery is located in Offida, which is the most typical area for the winery of Piceno area. Here, and in the more specific for this winery, you can find only the autochthonal wine selection of our area. So I'm talking about Passerina, Pecorino, Trebbiano, Montepulciano, and Sangiovese that we use for the production, for example, of Rosso Piceno Superiore. The winery counts of 30 hectares, and they produce only organic and vegan wines. In the last years, they've decided to focus on the organic and vegan wines. The wine you will taste today is Leo Guelfus. Is a Rosso Piceno Superiore DOC. It's a blend of Montepulciano and Sangiovese, 17% Montepulciano, 30% Sangiovese. This wine makes 18 months after the vinification, makes 18 months in barrique and tonneau, and then 3 months in bottle. The color is typical of this denomination. It's a ruby intense red with some shapes of violet. It's intense and full-bodied. You can find all the tasting notes which are typical of Rosso Piceno, like, for example, red fruits. Thank you.
Okay. Question? Bene, nel rispetto dei tempi siamo riusciti a stare nelle 2 ore. Un grazie a tutti quanti voi e speriamo di avervi lasciato un buon ricordo ed esempio di questa nostra, diciamo, regione nei suoi, diciamo, vini. Grazie.
So, we finished perfectly on time after 2 hours. Thank you for being here. We hope that you will cherish the memory of the wines of the Marche region that you tasted today. Thank you.